Okay, let's see. That's better. Cool. Carb log. I got some coffee. I got a medium this time. Yes, I am wearing the same shirt as yesterday. Don't judge me. I'm gonna go get some ramen. My birthday's tomorrow. I gotta get some gas first, though. So we're gonna get some gas. And get some Jinya. I got it for pickup. It's much cheaper that way. When I go there, I always spend like $50. Tip and everything. The ramen is like $18. So it's like, I don't want to spend that. So instead I just get two ramens. Anyway, I hope you guys are having a good day. A good weekend so far. I think the gas station is up here. So fed up. What's with it seems? No!
Make a U-turn.
We're gonna mute that for a second. I think there's a gas station up here. I'm pretty sure there's a QT up here. I only trust QT. Long live the QT fans. Yeah. Anyway, whoa, the sun's all shining. Sorry about that. I got these cool ass sunglasses too. My birthday's tomorrow though. I'm excited! I'm gonna go get my nails done. My toes. They don't really need to be done, but I could use them being done again. I'm gonna get a massage. Hopefully. We'll see if I can get scheduled for tomorrow. I have a massage ticket, like a ticket to get a free massage. I'm gonna go eat at IHOP in the morning. I love IHOP. And now I'm gonna take myself to the melting pot. I thought I was gonna get a free meal, but please don't crash into me. I don't know why these people are driving stupidly, okay? Don't get mad at me. But the melting pot is really good. I think I described it in my last video. It's just like a fondue place. Why is this guy, he has a BMW, of course. Oh. And then we got these guys. I feel like a dick now. Maybe that's what it was. I don't know. Anywho, thanks for those who watched my video. I'm gonna put a lot of random yap sessions on YouTube. Feel free to listen to them. They're really just, I like to question why on things, like literally everything. So they're just things I think about and things I would question and wonder. Nothing I say is absolute truth, although I take it as my truth. You don't have to take it as your truth, okay? But I do appreciate open-minded people, and I even appreciate people who listen to what I say and even come back with what their thoughts and opinions are with their own truth system, like their philosophies or whatever we're talking about, you know? I think there's a QT up here. You're a QT. Ha! 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 Sorry. Anyway. Finally, my joints are feeling a little better. So nice. Doesn't take too long, which is good. Now that I figured out what foods to eat to get my joints to feeling better, it doesn't take too long. Nice! Lots of yogurt. Lots of broth. Which is why I'm getting Jinya. Because I'm hungry, and I think the broth will help me even more. I've been craving broth. I've been craving ginger, and I think it's because of the broth. I've been getting this weird-ass vibe lately. I think I talked about this in my videos before. It's like a feeling of a certain energy. Like, I'm in a room, but I'm not in a room, obviously. I'm driving. So weird. I keep getting it, like, the last few days. But usually, the picture is clear of what that room would be like. Oh, my phone's like multi-window, blah blah blah. But hold on, I'm trying to look for a spot. Anyway, when I get these weird feelings, it's like a very clear picture of where it's at and what it is and everything. This time it's just like this overall sense. Okay, I gotta get gas. And hopefully this lady redirects me to ramen. Otherwise, this is going to be a short stream anyway, so I might have to edit it anyway. So, uno momento. I gotta turn off the car. What am I thinking? I'm done. What am I even thinking? I don't like leaving this unlocked. I don't want to be hijacked. Is that better at all? Let's see. Anyway, tomorrow's my birthday. What? And there's literally no one who can ruin it this year. How fucking nice. Usually I'm dating someone or I'm friends with someone who's like an absolute asshole. And they do something to just kind of... Nobody really ruins it for me, but they try to. They really try to. It's fucking annoying. Anyway, this year, no one. I'm gonna celebrate alone. I like celebrating my shit alone. A lot of people think that's sad, but I like it. It is what it is. Okay, let's see if this lady redirects me. I'm gonna have to flip a bitch.
South 48th Street.
Old school 2003 BM or Mini Cooper in front of me. I just saw this guy staring at me at the gas station. Now he's crossing the street. Anyway, be prepared for lots of weird videos. I have a very weird mindset. One that I can't say I run into often, and I get ridiculed a lot for it, so here we go. Not right now, this is gonna be a chill video. We're gonna go get ramen. Oh shit, they didn't give us the arrow, what the hell? What the hell? This car may contain an asshole. That's funny. That car wouldn't have stopped. He would have gotten smashed. guys see who this is. He's up here at the same light, which is so funny. I don't know why he had to rush in front of those people. I never get that. Whatever. Oh, you can't see it, but it could ride on their front window. I need to do that. I used to ride around with a hoodie, but I don't have the same OnlyFans name. I have to have my friend make me a different hoodie. So it had my old name on it. Now it's got a different one.
For 4 miles.
Okay, lady. Ooh, garage sales! I forgot those exist. I'm so excited to be able to go to those. Soon. My joints are completely better. Gut feelings can feel like they're intuitional and sometimes they're just not, you know. You gotta be able to differentiate, so I took time to learn. And now I feel like I'm on the right track. I've never been happier in my life. I've never been in this good of health. I've never been in this good of a financial position. Even though I'm not like amazingly like stable, I'm able to pay rent every month. I'm able to feed my dogs a good diet. I'm able to feed myself a good diet. I don't have to work my ass off like day in and day out to make sure I have a roof over my head. And that's where the real luxury is just those having the quiet days and being able to do nothing and like get people into my platforms to make money, to sub and stuff like that. That's the life that I'm trying to build up. Before, I didn't really understand what I was doing, but now I've understood like this gift, so to speak, this opportunity that I have. Like, this is, there's so much ways that I have right now that I could earn money overnight if I just build these up. So I was like, okay, let me do that, you know? For a bit, 7777, as I was literally just talking about this. Anyway, so cool. Anyway, but, oh, this guy's talking to himself. He's like, what? See that Trump shit? It's all fake, okay? I don't want to hear any of it. It's all fake, all right? It's staged. Yes, the media would still report on it, even if it's staged. It's all just an act to keep you entertained, to keep you distracted, so you're not looking on what's over here, which is Project 2025, Agenda 47, and such other things. Anyway, we won't get into that. But nonetheless, I'm very excited. And I'm very, very serious about my spiritual path and my
physical. Turn right onto South 16th Street.
My health and everything like that. So that's why I know it's gonna go well, because it's something that I've always wanted and I just worked so hard to figure out how to get towards it. Not having it is not an option. Does that make sense? Like,
at the light, turn right onto South 16th
Street. That's where, if there's a will, there's a way kind of thing. That's where that comes from. If you really, really want it, no matter what gets in your path, you will view that as an obstacle and not the end of the line. You will view it as redirection, a chance to rest and refigure things out, but never a chance to quit. Never. And that just proves how badly you want things, right?
Continue on South 16th Street for 6 miles.
And what's funny is, like, I was talking in my other video how these girls with, like, high followings will copy my shit and make me, like, pretend I don't exist at the same time. Like, you know, it irritates me, but at the same time, that's how I know in my heart I feel like I'm gonna be able to build my platforms really big. Because in the past, I've been able to have big ass platforms without even trying. It's accidental, it just happens. And if I really intentionally do it, then I think it will happen even more. And on top of that, like, I kind of know what I'm doing now. Before, I didn't, because it was accidental, I didn't really know what to do with it. And I'm preparing myself for lots of ways that I want my future to go and just kind of manifesting that. And I really keep to myself. I really just make sure my energy is always in the correct state. I don't fuck with people who fuck with my energy. Simple as that. It doesn't matter if I have to cut them off. It doesn't matter if we're best friends or whatever. I'm really so serious about my energy, my spiritual path, my future, my goals, my money, everything. And these girls that have big platforms, if they're copying me, then I feel like obviously I can get there. If they're copying me, then I've got the it factor. Whatever it is, I don't fucking know, but nonetheless, I'll just keep being me, keep doing my thing, and we'll get there with consistency, right? July, I don't know how consistent I'll be. I think YouTube, I'll probably be more consistent, which is fine. I think I'm going to take a break from streaming in July is what I'm going to do. I might stream a little bit tonight and tomorrow on my birthday. Just because people ask me, like, are you going to stream on your birthday? I really wasn't planning to, but I will a bit just to say hi to people. Happy birthday, thank you. You know, whatever. Thanks for making me feel special, though. I appreciate that. It's more so that I'm almost burnt out. So I'm very weary of where my energy is spent right now. And it's only spent on things that I really want to do, which is the vlogging. I was going to live stream, like I said in my other video. I was going to live stream a lot of this stuff my birthday week, but I think I'll just vlog it. I'm running out of space on my fucking thing. If you want, I have a phone in my Amazon wish list. I need another phone for like work stuff. So if you want to be super generous, there's a phone on my Amazon wish list. I'm not trying to be pushy. I'm just saying if there's anyone who wants to. Dude, I'm trying to get over. Crazy lady. I'm just so excited. With my joints feeling better, like, oh my god, so many adventures. I'm so excited to vlog. And it kind of just makes sense, I guess, now that I think of it, that I want to go into the direction of vlogging more. Like, I want to focus on my YouTube, but it's hard with my TikTok. But my TikTok isn't lifting off because people keep reporting my TikTok. And trolls and shit like that. Random bitches who fucking like to copy me but don't like me. I don't fucking know. Anyway, childish people who don't have anything to do but hate. But nonetheless, I never really let people know my exact plans, and because I never know my exact plans. I just go by the day by day and how my gut feels. So I'm feeling YouTube is going to be my step for a bit. We'll be posting a lot of vlogs. This week I want to post a lot of vlogs of like where I'm going, my little birthday outings. Because this week I'm going to celebrate really hard. So every day I have like 3 different activities. And then the following week, like the first week, last week I just kind of stayed in bed a lot because my joints were really bad and stuff. So I didn't really count that week. But the first week of July I did a lot. And then this week I'm going to do a lot. Ooh, a pink cheek. But this week I'm going to do a lot, and then next week I'm going to do a lot, just for the sake of videos, because I needed to do 30 different, or 31 activities for my birthday month, so I want to complete all 31 activities, at least for the days, and like I said, this week has multiple activities, so anyway, I've been wanting to get out and explore. I'm so excited, and then when fall time comes, I have so much content ideas. Sith, oh! Sith 77, I love that. Sith Lord, I love that. My email is Sith Queen, and it's all blacked out GMC. It's real nice. Has a Darth Vader hitch stopper thingy, like on the outside of the hitch, whatever you call those. I don't know. Sorry. Anyway. Yeah, if you have autoimmune illnesses, like, I've been in this flare since I was 20, so, like, I had to be really mindful about what activities I could do, like, barely could get my groceries, like, I needed someone to be there with me to help me walk to get my groceries if I was gonna go get groceries, like, that's been since I was 20, and I was dating bad people around that time, I was not with the best of friends and stuff like that, surrounding myself with really not good people. And people who were just using me. And which is funny because at that point I really didn't understand what there would be to use about me. So I felt like I had to give a lot to them. And now I know why they were using me, you know? It's just the difference, the night and day difference. Oh, wow. This is a cool little church thing. I wonder if I can stop over here. That is cool. Weird. Cool. But... yeah! Oh my god, I'm so excited. I just haven't been able to get out or do anything. I'm excited to do live streams while grocery shopping. Like, I have not grocery shopped. I'm excited to go to the Asian markets. I'm excited to go to any kind of ethnic food market because I like those. I don't really get to explore those foods much. So, like, going to those little markets, it's like a little store usually. So, I feel really safer in there when it's a small store. As opposed to, like, if it was like a Walmart size market, I would feel too overwhelmed. So I like going to little markets, Russian markets, I don't know what you call it, like Arabic food markets, Muslim food, I don't really know what the term would be, sorry, Arabian food markets, I'm not sure, but whatever it is, delicious, Asian markets, stuff like that. I love going to those. I love the candies. I like trying things that, like just the snacks and just seeing what they have. It's always, I love culture, anthropology, psychology. I love just how learning how humans work And not just on the surface of, like, here and now, just, like, down through cultural, whatever, through ancestral lineage, decades of things, you know, conditioning, whatever it might be. There's so much to it, and it's so fascinating. And it's really fascinating how moldable humans are even at an adult age. The government knows that. Anyway. but, yeah. I just have been cooped up for so long. I'm so excited to have my health back. And now knowing that I have to, it's imperative that I have oregano oil, garlic, yogurt. Okay, so every day my medicine is oil of oregano, fermented garlic, and then I drink a smoothie, a strawberry yogurt, Greek plain yogurt smoothie with strawberries, coconut oil, apple cider vinegar, and stevia and honey. A little half and half. That smoothie in itself is great for gut repair. So that's really important in my diet. And then that oil of oregano and the garlic. So, so important. And then I've been drinking a lot of chicken broth, chicken stock, collagen, good stuff in it. Good stuff in it for your gut. Repair that gut lining. And I've been just going heavy on that. Heavy. And just 2 times a day, the smoothie thing. Two, three, four times even. Anytime I kind of get hungry, I do the broth. And then the garlic and oil of oregano are morning and night. And if it's real bad, like my joints, I'll do three times a day dose. Like an antibiotic, essentially. So that's kind of what they're acting as. Anyway, I'll do a separate video on that. So I know there's a lot of people with gut issues when you have autoimmune illnesses. Happy to help. Super happy to help with that. For free. You just gotta watch the video so I can tell you. That's all. Oh my god, y'all. Figure your shit out. There's these people going into the turn lane. Bickering with each other through cars. The Crystal Loft. Oh yeah, tomorrow I'm supposed to go find a rainbow moonstone. I love rainbow moonstones. Last year my friend Sierra got me a moonstone. I didn't know too much about moonstones then, but now I learned there's different moonstones. And because I'm a Cancer, and Cancers are the moon sign, right? We're ruled by the moon and everything, so. I really feel connected to moonstones, and I really want to get some rainbow moonstone, and it's really important for me to do a ritual on my birthday. And I really want to have that rainbow moonstone. So I'm excited because tomorrow I'm going to go find me some rainbow moonstone. it'd be nice if I could go get it in,
turn left onto Thomas Road.
In Jerome. But I have a trip planned in Jerome this month. So I'll get myself a crystal then as well when I'm able to walk better. So I'll have multiple crystals this month. Ooh, I'm so excited. This is just going to be such a good month for manifesting. Such a good month. Whoa.
At the light, turn left onto Thomas Road.
I'm just stoked because my joints being better is like everything to it. Everything falls in line when my joints are good. So I really want to take my health super serious. Oh my god, this dude's staring at me in the fucking car next door. I can feel when dudes stare at me. Like, I hate it so much. I really do. And what I hate even more is when I say that, I always get some fucking buffoon online who's like, yeah, but you look like that. Like, I should be able to look however I want without dudes fucking staring and, like, gawking at me. Like, he's trying to get my attention over here. And it's fucking annoying. Like, I'm not really the kind where I don't mind being perceived. Like, I like how I look. I know that it draws attention, etc., etc. But when dudes start acting fucking weird as shit, it's like, really? Can we have some class?
One mile.
serotonin and dopamine is just so up there. It's so up there. For many reasons, because I've been locked up, so like everything gives me dopamine. Everything. Everything out here gives me dopamine. This little garbage can, I've never seen a garbage can like that. Life is cool. Oh, look at these buildings. They look like little Italian, like, trellises, you know, with the balconies. So cute. Anyway, but on top of that, when you have depression, it's really true that fixing your diet is the best way to mitigate things. Exercise will help, but the right diet is, it's not just about eating healthy. You can eat healthy, but you have to eat the right foods together. That's why that smoothie is so important, because I put an avocado smoothie, avocado, strawberries, coconut oil, Greek yogurt, plain, and honey. Apple cider vinegar as well. They all have a particular function in the gut and small intestine. Apple cider vinegar, especially the Bragg's with the mother on the bottom, it's great for antifungal, like candida, antibacterial. Same with coconut oil. It's great for antimicrobial, antibacterial. Honey is a great antibacterial, anti-inflammatory, antimicrobial. Plain Greek yogurt is a great antibacterial and has good bacteria. What is it called? Lactobacillium or something like that. It's great, great fermented, lactose fermented bacteria that fights the bad bacteria in the small intestine. Which the foods that we eat, in America especially, anywhere, if you eat an overabundance of overprocessed food, you will get sick like this. In many different ways. It'll look different. It can look like fibromyalgia. This is my belief. It can look like fibromyalgia, lupus, diabetes, POTS. It all comes down to small intestinal bacterial overgrowth. SIBO. S-I-B-O. That's just my belief. But I've lived it because I've literally experimented with my body since I've been fucking a kid. And I tried to get this relayed to doctors. They don't believe me or whatever. I don't give a shit. But what I do know is now that my health is better, there's things happening in a spiritual way. It's hard to describe. Connections of the mind. And it's, yeah, interesting to say the least. There's thoughts, but like good thoughts, like thoughts that are just like, so I don't want to say advanced because it makes me seem like I'm a genius or some shit. It's not that. It's not, it's more of like epiphanies, but they're advanced to me. I'm like, oh, the connections that I'm connecting right now for my life, like why things are happening, and this is now the path I have to go because now I'm seeing why those things happen, so I need to continue this path because of that, you know, or whatever. The fuck? There's an abandoned building and there's a picture of Joseph Stalin on the front. What the fuck? What the fuck was that? Anyway, you know, I could be fucking loony at the end of it, who knows? All I know is I don't know. I've wanted a certain thing in my life and I'm about to get it. I'm about to get it. I didn't really expect ever to do the OF and shit like that, but here I am. But it would be nice to blow up on that and be able to start a restaurant or a bar from that and not have to rely on the bar for money for living. So that can just be a source of creativity for me, and that way I feel like that will make me more money rather than going in with the money mindset. I know that sounds loony. Just let me do it before you say anything, okay? Let me test the theory myself before anybody shits all over my idea. Because I believe it's true. Pearson Street. I don't know how much battery my phone has. Let's see. 37%. Okay, we're fine. Oh, so many pretty trees. Oh, excited because this month, like, I've been waiting for my health to get better so that I can do certain activities. And I actually even have more of a theory. 777 again. That these are, like, just connections that I have in my life. So I had a friend, and for a while, I really didn't feel like she meant well by me. I think she masqueraded it, but I didn't really think it was genuine. And at that point, she had done several things where she had proved that, you know. And I still kept her around just because I just really didn't want to believe it. But the time, last time I met with her, I was really hoping my health would be better by that time. And 777 again! What? That's crazy. Anyway, but at that point, I was really believing that my health would be better, but it wasn't. And I really believe if I hadn't invited her, my health would have been better. But nonetheless, now I think it's important that I celebrate my birthday alone. As stupid as that sounds, and my Christmas alone. Like, I'll be inviting family over for Christmas, but Christmas Day, I will be celebrating it alone. With my dogs, of course. When I say alone, it means me and my doggos. Never alone with my dogs and the thoughts. I'm just kidding. Anyway, we're almost there. I'm going to leave you guys in here because it's just an in and out. Quick in and out. Okay. 1 second. Ugh. You guys can stay in here. Behave yourself. I'll be back. Five, five, five out here. Damn. Wanna be my lover. That's the song. They always have the bumping music out there. I hope these people didn't look at my coochie. Oh, shit, how do I get back? I don't know. I don't know! What are these people doing? I don't know. With their super expensive Mercedes. Thanks for hanging out with me, y'all. But yeah, if you're an autoimmune baddie, boy or girl, doesn't matter. Feel free to follow my channel. I've been really taking time to investigate things with my body and shit like that. I'm sorry, mate. I kind of took up the whole driveway there. So I would love to help people with this. I'm not certified or anything. I looked into getting a certified nutritionist certification or whatever. That takes a lot of, like, what do you call it, in training, like, in-house work or whatever. Like, I would have to be practicing with a physician or something for, like, 6 months. And obviously, to get to that point, I have to have some sort of medical licensing under my belt, like, from a school, right? That's not really what I'm trying to do. Although I want to go to school, I want to have more information to give me. I don't like school because I don't like the prereqs. I don't care to go through all of the shit that I went through in high school all for that. Especially because I took honors and AP classes. The fact that I still had to take prereqs really fucking irritated me. So I just dipped out. But do I love learning about that shit? Absolutely. And I think certifications are valuable because it shows that you've gained the knowledge, you know? So I feel like I'm at that level where I could. But it just takes a lot of, like, inpatient work. So I'm trying to figure out a way I can get certified where it's just me learning stuff and showing that I know this stuff and I know how to do things correctly. But I hope that on that way, like, I can help people and actually help them. 666. 999. What is up with all of these fucking numbers, dude? It's a little insane. A little overboard universe. Anyway. but so many beautiful murals over here. I can't wait for fall because I'm going to take photo shoots in front of all of them. Look at this cool. It's a dragon and a knight. Cool as fuck. Anyway, they have a lot of murals like that. Do photo shoots in front of them with, like, matching clothes. But yeah, I know for people with autoimmune illnesses, it's literally like being a prisoner of your body. And for a while, that's exactly how I thought of it. It sucks so much. But now knowing when I don't have yogurt, broth, and stuff in my diet, I need it in my diet. I really absolutely need it. Because when you have an autoimmune illness, your immune system doesn't function as good. So you actually have more, this is all my opinion, okay? These are things I've read and stuff, but there's no, like, science, like, coming out with all of these as, like, straight fact, okay? This is very controversial what I talk about, because I talk about this with my doctor, who's like, you're nuts. Anyway, I know I'm not nuts because I've done it several times in my life. So, but, yeah, you just got to balance out the bad bacteria in your gut. So, you know, really you got to learn how to utilize that bacteria instead of killing it. And doctors like to kill it off with antibiotics and shit like that. I don't think that's the way to go. I think harmony, state of homeostasis, neutralizing. So you can eat those things, just make sure you're taking in the appropriate amount of fermented foods. Did you know back in the day, ketchup and mustard were fermented? They're no longer fermented. The fermentation process has been traded with high fructose corn syrup, which is what's exactly making us all sick. And then you ban high fructose corn syrup, and guess what? They just add corn syrup. They're always gonna find a way around it. And honestly, what's even crazier is everybody buys high fructose corn syrup, right? If they made it a law that any food that has a sweet derivative, it can't be a byproduct. It has to be like a natural, like sugar, honey, molasses, maple syrup, agave syrup. Like it can't be anything other than those, you know? Then you would see actually the prices of those go down because manufacturers are forced to purchase those products. And even though it's a high price now, because those products are high priced now because they don't get the volume of purchases that they need. If there was a law that cut out those products and you have to buy sugar, you have to buy honey, you have to buy maple syrup instead of high fructose corn syrup and corn syrup, you have to, or like Splenda or like aspartame or whatever the hell, like you can't buy those things anymore. It has to be the real deal sweet stuff in there, you know? Then every manufacturer is going over to buy sugar, honey, blah, blah, and because there's such a high, you know, amount, everybody wants it. Yeah, I guess they could jack up the price, but also there's so much of it that they don't really need to. I think that they could easily just lower the cost because they're getting so much pay from these big manufacturers. It's now more of an affordable option because they're getting paid big bucks by the manufacturers. They can sell it to the smaller people for a little bit less now because they're making their big money with the manufacturers and obviously with us too, but the big money comes from the people who buy from them in bulk, the manufacturing people who buy from the manufacturers. That's how my mind works anyway. I could be completely wrong on that. I don't own a manufacturing company, you know, but I do think when you make that switch, the energy redirects, so to speak. Could work. I don't know. But yeah, ketchup and mustard used to be fermented, which is really good for your gut. Anything fermented is good for your gut. That's kind of why wine, a glass a day, is good for your gut. Everything in moderation. I'm learning that. America has really hard issues with what moderation looks like. Well, a lot of countries do. Just with this processness coming about, moderation does not really exist. So I do think, you know, in a world where everything is at our fingertips, practicing moderation is even more important. And especially because the things that are really at our fingertips are just so bad for us. Food-wise, energy-wise, everything. Like, the things that are not at our fingertips, like the healthy food, the real knowledge that you have to dig for and shit, like, that stuff is all kind of tucked away. The bad, real bad stuff, the easy, low-hanging fruit, I guess you could call it, is right there. Just right there. Ew. I hate when dudes spit. It's literally so gross. Like, so gross. Why do you do that? Why do you need to get rid... Just swallow your spit like a normal person. I don't... Ooh, that looks cool. Yeah, I can't wait because I look forward to the cool months. My joints are gonna feel good. Lots of photo shoots. I hope my friend Sierra will be willing to tag along. She's gonna be a beautiful subject for my photo shoots, but also help her get her social media started more. Want some of us? Soluble fiber, because that's how you don't get all blocked up. And then you drink enough water, you know. So it's not really about, for some people like myself, I have to moderate things a lot. But when you start killing off this bacteria and really getting to like a neutral point with your body, you can actually just enjoy normal things again. I was eating fast food, I was eating brownies, I was drinking beer, just normal. But I went a week without yogurt, without broth, and I spent like 2 to 3, 4 days just in bed. My hip, I had to bring out my scooter again. Like, so now I know. Now I know. And it's a learning process, you know? But I'm really glad because I've been on heavy medicine since I was 6. And I'm really glad to be healing myself, and I'm really glad I didn't listen to my doctors. I know that sounds crazy. Don't not listen to your doctors. Please listen to your doctors, okay? Unless you're willing to study yourself, you know, and study your intuition and, you know, things like that. But don't just, like, if you need certain medicine and it's keeping you alive, don't just go off of it, you know. It's taken me a long time to get to this point. And I would never recommend completely taking yourself off medicine. Like I said, with even the bad bacteria, you can use both Western and holistic medicine. I, as a matter of fact, do. And I highly recommend. Because I don't think, with if you have such a severe illness like myself, there's, you know, no way you're really going to get better if you don't start introducing those good bacteria. I don't know where I'm going. I'm trying to get home. But I can't look up my fucking GPS. But if you have health issues, I just recommend homemade chicken broth stock. It has to have chicken bones. It has good collagen and gut health stuff. Okay. Make sure you eat plain Greek yogurt. I always feel bad for the puppies, but for the homeless puppies, but I think they actually enjoy it, to be honest. They like being outdoors, they get to walk around a bit, you know, they feel safe with their human, and usually the human takes care of them pretty well, substantially better than themselves, from what I've seen. So I try not to feel too bad for the puppies, but I do know when I feed the homeless again, I do want to have little bags of dog food. I actually have started transitioning my dogs to a cooked diet. My door is open. So I have quite a bit of dog food left. Puppies. And they're wearing shoes. I love that. I would love to, I said this before, I would love to try to partner with some company that does dog feet sticker thingies. Maricopa County Courthouse. Why is it serving cunt? It's like courthouse. Cunt house? Maricopa County? Cunt house? Cunt cunt? Just kidding. Anyway. Yes. My door is not open. Stop lying to me. Okay, where am I going? I'm gonna go straight. Because I think I can. I need to learn how to get home one way or another. Unless my phone dies or the camera stops, then I can just look it up. Yeah. Jackson. And turn left. So I think that's what I gotta do. Oh my god, my door isn't open. Stop lying to me. I don't know why it does that. It's a sensor is going out or something. This is what I get for not using my GPS. This is a cool ass building though. I do scope out these empty buildings so that perhaps I will use it for my restaurant one day. Can I go down 3rd Street? I think I can. This is nowhere where I need to be. We'll figure it out. Arizona is like a grid system, so it's really difficult to get lost if you know a few streets around here. Lincoln. 3rd Street. this car too. My door's not open. Anyway, I'm so stoked. I'm so excited. And thank you for everyone who's watching my shenanigans, because you don't really know what I'm excited for, but I'll sit down here today and be making a few videos after I upload this one. Kind of like to give you guys just some info of like my life and like where I was up until this point. 7th Street and what? Okay, cool. It takes being alone without those kind of people in your ear to gaslight you to realize what they're doing is wrong, how they're making you feel is wrong. And you could even carry that from years of like how your parents treated you from when you were a kid, you know? You gotta sit down and talk with yourself. People say that's loony, but you gotta do it. You're the only one who knows your inner brain and inner workings and everything like that. 6 8s in a row. 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8. Okay. Today must be a crazy. Well, it's the day before my birthday, so I'm feeling it. Good things. Billionaire, I would just renovate all these abandoned houses, because A, I love abandoned houses, they're cool as fuck. Renovating it would be cool as fuck. And then I would just give it to a homeless person and get them set up with life. Program to get clean. You have to stay clean to stay in this house. You need to be working this amount of hours. You don't have to worry about rent or anything like that. You know, this is your home. But there will be like probationary, like inspections and stuff like that, and some people think that's a violation of privacy, but it's really about, you know, getting you off these substances and making sure you can be functional in society in a productive way, however you deem that fit, you know. I don't think, yeah, I have a whole theory with that too, but anyway, I'm excited to eat this ramen. And I gotta eat so much garlic today. Drink a smoothie or two. I got plenty of broth in here, so I don't gotta worry about broth. I don't know if I'll eat both of these today. I might. Probably not. I have tacos too. My foods that I'm really attached to right now are ramen from Jinya. In-N-Out protein style burger that I get. And then the carne asada tacos with some homemade guac. Fucking, it's a caution, guys. Right? Because red blinking means you have to those thoughts. Am I wrong on that? Yellow just means proceed with caution. If it's blinking yellow. Someone correct me. I don't all the time know the correct street laws. I'll be honest with you. Okay, I don't know everything. But I always thought yellow blinking meant just proceed with caution. Yield kind of thing. And then blinking red means stop. Like a four-way cross. Four-way stop sign. I gotta go to the farmer's market. I'm excited. It's really easy for me to get healthy, so to speak, or like go into remission with this food because I used to binge food all the time because I knew sugar was bad for me, so I'd binge sugar and then not and go without it for a few months or a few weeks or whatever. So, now that I know if I'm healthy, I can have it in a little bit, it's easier for me to stick to my diet. It's more of a lifestyle that I have to stick to now, but it's always, like, the smoothies I gotta have 2 times a day. That yogurt does me so good. The oil of oregano, the garlic, I have to have 2 times a day. That avocado, 2 times a day. Coconut oil, 2 times a day. Apple cider vinegar, 2 times a day. I hate apple cider vinegar alone. So that's why I put it in my smoothie. And kind of the fat and stuff of the yogurt carries a lot of the nutrients in the things that I need. Because a lot of things are fat soluble and you need fat to help it digest properly. And that's why, actually, I don't really believe in supplements and I never have, but I just learned recently a big thing which confirms why I believe in the supplement shit. But supplements are pretty much like, they're just synthetic. They're derived from like a one compound of that item. So a lot of things have multiple compounds to them to support the growth of that one vitamin, you know? like a lot of fruit has vitamin E, vitamin C, vitamin B, like, and maybe vitamin D or some calcium or whatever. A lot of those are needed to aid each other in the digestion and absorption and everything like that. When you extract them like that, you don't not really absorb them. And when they're dehydrated that way, they're pretty much nothing. You're like incinerating them till they're powder. So there's really no nutritional benefits, in my opinion. That's just because I tried supplements and it never worked for me. Everybody's like, oh, do these supplements. And I'm just like, okay, what can I eat naturally that I can get that from, you know? That's all. So, if you're feeling like, and the thing is if you're craving certain foods, then it will tell you exactly what's wrong with you. I know that sounds crazy, but it will. If you're craving too much sugar, if you're craving too much carbs, like, it's very likely you have a candida overgrowth, bacterial fungal overgrowth of some sort. Now, I'm not a doctor. Take it for a grain of salt, okay? I've just been reading. This is, like, something that I am, like, so interested in. I love reading about. Because I've been wheelchair bound. I've had a miserable childhood growing up. I wouldn't say miserable because I would somehow find the silver lining. But it was difficult with this illness. And now that I know I don't have to be as dependent on medicine and, like, I can thrive if I just eat certain foods in my diet. And I don't even mind. And coconut, in general, coconut oil, coconut milk is so good for you. It helps with bacteria and everything like that. So I'm actually thinking of just making myself, like, pina colada type drinks at a point, too, because the pineapple is so good. So I'm thinking, like, in the morning, I'll probably make myself, like, a pina colada type smoothie because the pineapple is good for digestive enzymes and helps break things down in the belly and whatnot. But and that night, I'll do, like, a strawberry coconut smoothie. Strawberry and coconut together taste like the pink Sobe drink. So if you have any reason to try these, this smoothie, it's because it tastes like a pink Sobe drink, but it's a smoothie and it's healthy, okay? That's literally why I drink it. But that's why I've always been on that. I've always been on, like, I don't believe that these things are, like, you have to never have them again in your life. I think you can have them. I think you can find natural ways to have them, or you just have to have the other ways in moderation. You know, and even natural ways should be in moderation. If you overconsume one thing, then, you know. And I've actually quite learned that at least my body it works in seasons with the foods. It's kind of crazy. Anyway, enough of this yap session. I love y'all. I'm about home. I'm going to enjoy some ramen. I'm going to be doing another little video, but I'll be uploading this. Oh my God, my door is not open. But love y'all. Take care of yourselves. Hydrate. Eat. Maybe make some chicken stock for your belly to feel good, okay? I'm happy to help anyone. If you have questions, let me know. Anyway, thanks for watching my video. Like, subscribe, share, whatever. Anyway, thanks for listening. Take care of yourself. Bye-bye.